All right, well, good afternoon. It is the first Friday in the month of April. So welcome, guys. We've been trying to call all, actually, as of today, I have called every student in Reflection School Dance, checking in on their household. Sounds like most people are doing really, really well. And so that was great to have a good report. We're staying healthy. We are following the governor's instructions, and hopefully we're gonna move past this season in our life pretty quickly. In the meantime, we're very sorry that we're not able to run classes here at the studio. Zoe and I are here, but this is like an extension of my house here. But we thought we can run live classes, and then everything that's being run live, it is also recorded. So you guys can access these classes at any time. We're gonna go ahead and record a basic tap class. It's open for tap 1, 2, and 3. My challenge to the tap 3s will be the combination we teach today, which is switch up the music on it and try it at a whole different pace. Miss Savannah came to the studio earlier this week, and she did record recital choreography, and she put classes together that have already been placed online. So please feel free to access those also. And then we are very available to all of you students. You can call us on the phone at the office, you can send a text, you can email. Any of the online live Zoom classes, you can participate in them. You don't have to be the one that you're actually signed up for. So it's one of the benefits of doing these online classes. We're very aware that it's not the same as being at the studio, and we'd love to be there so we can high five you and all that stuff. But in the meantime, you can take advantage of as many classes as you'd like to, whether it's your forte or not. So this is tap. Got my tap shoes on, okay? I moved into Studio B. We've been recording our classes over in Studio A because it just looks nicer on camera, but this is our tap floor. So one of the rules, especially younger kids that might be jumping on, you are welcome to order shoes actually through our website. Go to Reflection School of Dance and use the little online store. You can order yourself some shoes. I think everything's still being shipped as normal, so they could be here within a week. If you do want to get them, your mom's okay with it, you do need to have a special designated floor at your house. So either dad can put down a piece of plywood in the garage, you can get some leftover linoleum if there was a house project that happened and you just have a scrap of linoleum. You really only need about maybe 3 by 4 feet, but you just don't want to use your tap shoes on your mom's hardwood floors. She will not be happy, and I won't be happy either, because she'll be scraping up the floor. And that's why we have a special marley floor here at the studio for that. So, all right, so if we do have any younger kids that are kind of going to check this out later, we got the front of the tap and the back of the tap. Sometimes you're going to be using just the toes. Sometimes we just use the heel. Sometimes we use both at the same time. Often you're using a portion of the foot, like on a shuffle, you're kind of sliding out and in, or you're just tapping really quickly. So we have good control for our feet. So I'm gonna scoot back a little bit and just let's circle those ankles, loosening up. Zoe thinks that looks silly. I'm gonna turn sideways. What about this, Zoe? Is this silly too? Okay. Yeah, see, there's so many ways you can warm up your ankles, guys. And other foot, circle those ankles. Change direction. All right, soles of your feet together, butterflies. And the reason I've got a chair randomly sitting here in the center, that's actually our bar. Sometimes we just warm up for tap in the center of the room. Often we do start at the bar and then we move to center, just like ballet class. All right, knees together, grab your toes. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And coming up under your 2 feet, squatting position, try to balance without dropping forward or dropping backward. Alrighty, stretch and straighten those legs. All right, I'm just gonna go ahead and start putting some music on. I'm gonna teach this class as if a student has just logged on, just bought their tap shoes for the first time, and it's all new to them. As I mentioned earlier, we've got some of the older girls that happen to log on and they need a dance challenge. Please learn the same steps and switch up the music. If you have a chance to video yourself and send it back to us, we would love to see it. We've got some different dance challenges that are going on. We've had people dancing outside. The choreography that I taught on the very first day that we ran online classes with the dance teams here in this studio, we did challenge you to choreograph that and switch it up, and we did have a few students that sent their video back. So that's really fun. Good way for us to stay in contact with each other. All right. 5, 6, 7, 8. And then you can either change the chair or turn the other way. Front, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Side, jack.
And on my chest, I hear the thunder, it's gonna roll.
Back.
And on my chest, hold on, we're gonna run it.
Underneath.
It makes you shake up, and what a friend is stuck.
2, 3, 4. Your taps a little faster.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Back.
3, 4, 5, 6.
Front.
5.
Back. 5. Back. Under. Front. Side. Back. Stay together, pick up your heel. If you're sideways, the balls of the feet stay on the floor, the heel flex. Try to lift the toes, heels down. Underneath, heel, heel, toe. Heel, heel, toe, chest, and heel, heel. Other side. Heel, heel, toe, toe. In preparation for later on, when Miss Savannah will teach you ground rules. Rocking back and forth, toes, heels, heels sideways. So you're changing the way to the back. You try.
On that chest.
All righty. Okay, quick explanation. Again, students that have been doing tap before, this basic warm-up beginning, you've done it all before. But just like when you come into ballet, you always do your plies. You might have thought, well, we did plies when we were 3 years old. And tap class, you might do your little tap. You were doing those when you were 3, and it's just a good way to get the feet and ankles loosened up. All righty, so prepping for a pigeon toe, one foot forward, one foot back. You just put the heel into the floor, and then the toe goes in, out, okay? Just with the tap rhythm, we're gonna do 7 of those and quick step change. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, step change. Then we'll do 3. 1, 2, 3, step change. 1, 2, 3, step change. In, out, in, step change. So we'll start with our 7. And in slow. In, out. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, step change. Toes in, out. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, step change. In, out. 3, 4, heels stay down. Count to 3. 3, 2, 1, step change. 3, 2, 1, step change. 3, 2, 1, step change. Good, let's go back to the 7s, ready? 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, step change. 7, Left, no worries, we're gonna get
One, three. Two, one, three, two, one.
All right, I'm gonna put my bar away, which is the chair. All righty, I'm gonna start to teach some basic steps in center, and it's gonna actually gonna go into a combination of fist and knee, okay? So if we're just tapping, use the front of the foot. It wants to feel like the floor's kind of hot. You wanna quickly get your foot off the floor. If I tap down and leave it there, it's a different sound and it's a different step, okay? So listen to this. Four. It's two different steps, okay? If you pick up quickly, that's kind of makes a sharper, kind of almost a higher sound, and it sounds really good, okay? You could also be doing heel digs. Generally, you're gonna get a softer sound with the heel until you have the whole thing later on, okay? The toe, or heels, or flat. Okay, with this music, we're gonna go toe, heel, flat. Toe, heel, flat. Toe, heel, flat. Toe, heel, flat. I'll keep pausing the music because just for the sake of time, you don't need to practice that for 3 full minutes, okay? Really quick. So then you just start to put the different patterns together. and changes direction for variety and that kind of thing, okay? So our first step is going to be grapevine or falling off the log is the side and cross, the side and touch, side and cross, and side and touch. With this, I'm going to, when I go to the side, toe heel, cross front, toe heel, to the side, toe heel, shuffle ball change, shuffle ball change, okay? I didn't review ball change when I had the chair, I heard it's simply a rock back. Those of you that do jazz or any other dance form with us, you've done ball change, okay? So falling off the log with shuffle ball change is toe heel, cross front, to the side, shuffle ball change. Side, front, side. Alrighty. Alright, can we get this on Hit the Road, Jack? Our Zoom classes tend to go so quickly. I'm like, if I throw too much music out there, it just gets confusing. So we're going to go with the song that's familiar already from the warm up, okay? Ball change. This foot is free, then we're going to reverse it Variation of the Hollywood. Heel, 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 heel. Okay, awesome. So, three parts. I'm going to put four parts together in a combination. Looks like we have about 10 more minutes. That's plenty of time for us to complete a combination. And again, I'm going to stay with this same song for familiarity for today. But if you kind of feel like you've memorized it and you want to throw on a whole different song and put on a disco flair, do it and show it to me later. I'm going to see it off in camera. Okay, so quick review. We have toe, heel, toe, toe, heel, shuffle, shuffle, toe, heel, triple shuffle. Da, 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 da. Pop. Okay, now, after we go to the side, we're going to try it to the front. It's going to look a little interesting going right towards the camera, but it's still the full left double heel, but I'm going to try. Instead of sideways, it's towards you. Heel, heel. This foot is free. Brush, heel, ball change. We usually do ball change behind us. We do ball change to the side. This is the ball change to the front. Okay? Flap, double heel, brush, heel, ball change, pop. My left foot is now free, so I go the other way. Flap, double heel, brush, heel, ball change front, ball change, pop. Now, if you feel comfortable, you can do the hop. Pull it back. You're still going to have that foot that was free. It's going to be ready to go. It's just in a new direction. Okay? So to the front, black, double heel, brush heel, ball change, hop back, black, double heel, brush heel, ball change, hop back. Okay? Just that part. Nice and slow with music. Front and back.
Thank you.
Front. I love to say, are there any questions? But you're going to have to text me your questions or email me questions or call me on the phone. I'm happy, happy to talk to you. Going to run the dance one more time. So if you want to join, you can. If not, I'll be out here and we'll just finish up. If the class times out, know we love you. We look forward to seeing you in the studio as soon as possible. We're praying for each of you. God bless you. Please stay healthy. Okay, from the top.
Thank you.